The Buteyko method has built its reputation for helping people with asthma. Yet, COPD is not that different. The hallmark of asthma is that the obstruction in the airways is reversible, while with COPD it's irreversible. Yet, with medication and techniques such as the Buteyko method, there is some reversibility in COPD, while a lot of asthma patients have chronic obstruction. The exercise that one needs to do is CO2 training at low heart rate and low levels of CO2, at least initially. That means holding one's breath and performing a couple of steps, or if that's challenging, just holding the breath while seated. These exercises should be built up over time and expose the patient to higher levels of CO2. In my experience, one would benefit further by combining some mobility work in the training. Keep in mind that COPD patients have been found to have low scores in the control pose, both when performed during inhalation and exhalation. So assessing what is your score initially and monitoring it over time can also be extremely important. For more information on CO2 training and improving breathing biomechanics, check out the links in the description.